What is going on, everybody? It's Taylor Roberts, and welcome to Off the Deep End. If you're just joining us for the first time, we're in the middle of a Lady Gaga deep dive where we explore her artistry through her music and music videos, which means new Lady Gaga reactions until we reach the end of her discography. So make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit that bell button so you get notifications of when those new videos drop. Hop on over to Instagram, Twitter, Twitch. Give me a follow. Now, as I mentioned before during my album reaction, which if you'd like to watch it, you can watch it right up here. I just felt like it was made specifically to be seen live. And for some reason, a lot of you guys didn't think I liked the record, apparently, which goes to show that some of you didn't watch the whole entire video. But hey, that's okay. I still love you. But now we've reached the visuals, and I'm curious to see what the visuals are going to look like, because it's been kind of crazy to see just kind of shift in the art from the Fame era and then the Fame Monster. And now this being such a bigger album than those other two, I'm assuming the videos are going to be even bigger as well. But let's not waste any more time. Let's hop right into the video.
This is the manifesto of Mother Monster. On Goat, a government-owned alien territory in space, a birth of magnificent and magical proportions took place. But the birth was not finite, it was infinite. As the wombs numbered.
I really like the music, it's mixing it really mysterious and intense with that boom sound going on. But it looks like this goddess in this cube, the cube kind of faded away, and then there was like the stars just made this outline of like this uterus and the ovaries, which obviously, you know, symbolizing birth. And I really like how they've kind of like mirrored the images to create this weird kind of abstracty visual of this birth right here. It gives it this really kind of weird, almost unsettling kind of a feeling to it.
And the mitosis of the future began. It was perceived that this infamous moment in life is not temporal, it is eternal. And thus began the beginning of the new race, a race within the race of humanity, a race which bears no prejudice, no judgment, but boundless freedom. But on that same day, as the Eternal Mother hovered in the multiverse, another more terrifying birth took place. The birth of evil.
She just pulled a gun out? That had to be painful. But did anyone notice how the world of evil looks like a skull, but it's just made up of bodies? If you notice that, all the red bodies made up kind of like the outlining of a skull, which I think is pretty cool. The birth of that gun there, that hurt me a little bit. You know that weird feeling you get something, you're like, ugh, in your gut? That I got that feeling in my gut.
And as she herself split into two, rotating in agony between two ultimate forces, the pendulum of choice began its dance. It seems easy, you imagine, to gravitate instantly and unwaveringly towards good. But she wondered, how can I protect
it's looking like it was
so perfect?
Directed by Robert Rodriguez.
It doesn't matter if you love him or capital H-I-M. Just put your paws up. Because you were born this way, baby.
My mama told me when I was young, we're all born superstars. She pulled my hair, put my lipstick on.
Okay, I just want to kind of recap on what I've seen so far. So what I'm assuming is that there's the birth of this kind, this race, this species of human, I guess you could say, the birth of this world. There was the birth of good and there was the birth of evil, because good can't exist without evil. They always have to be together. And then we get this shot of everybody just seems to be kind of bowing down to someone. I don't know if it's the goddess. I don't know if it's the devil per se in this video, if you want to call him the devil. But it looks like they're bowing down to someone, almost as if like they're being ruled. And then you have Lady Gaga walk in and she's, you know, free. She's not bowing down. She's just kind of walking through everybody, gets down on the ground with them, and then suddenly they all start dancing, which to me, I feel is a way of symbolizing of Gaga kind of being that good and kind of freeing this society of whatever was holding them down or trapping them in some way.
Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Give yourself prudence and love your friends. Subway can rejoice the truth.
Okay, so now it looks like we got the evil. We got the evil side here with the skull makeup. But actually, I think that dude kind of looks familiar. I think he is like an actual, I think like those are his actual tattoos. But I just want to say she kind of, Lady Gaga kind of looked like Blake Lively when she walked in for some reason. I don't know why. Not saying Blake Lively looks like a skeleton, but she kind of, you know, she kind of had, I guess a mannerism or a stature of kind of how Blake Lively looked. I don't know. At quick glance, it kind of looked like Blake Lively, okay? Just let me have that.
In the religion of the insecure, I must be myself, respect my youth. A different law is not a sin. Believe capital H, I am. Hey, I love my life, I love this record, and me, I'm on it, vole, by guys. I'm beautiful in my way, cause God makes no mistakes. I'm on the right track, baby, I was born this way. Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Whether you're broke or evergreen, you're black, white, beige, Chola descent, you're Lebanese, you're Orient. Whether life's disabilities left you outcast, bullied, or teased, rejoice and love yourself today, cause baby, you were born this
no
way.
No man was born to be brave.
I just want to say that guy's expression has just been the same the whole entire video. It's the face you make when your girlfriend is just super annoying all of a sudden out in public, or your boyfriend, your significant other is just super annoying out in public, and you're like, "Will you shut up?" And like, "Oh my god, I can't believe I have to deal with you right now." That's that face, and he's been making it this whole entire video, just kind of mocking him a little bit. He's mocking evil a bit. Look at him, he's just done with her shit, yo.
Hey, same DNA, but born this
the very end there, she looked like Madonna. I feel like that's her little like sly at critics being like, she's just like Madonna, or she's copying Madonna. I feel like that's her being like, her little like, hey, fuck you. The Born This Way music video. Obviously, I think it has to do with good and evil and people and being freed of whatever is not allowing them to be who they want to be. And Gaga is the one who kind of comes in and frees everyone. Because that's what this song is about, right? It's about celebrating who you are as a person, what makes you you, and being okay with who you are, being happy with yourself, and freeing yourself from all of the other bullshit that doesn't really fucking matter in life. But I feel like it's conveying the same message. It's making fun of evil. It's showing the freedom of people as people are celebrating in that, you know, weird paint, whatever it was. I don't know what it was, but you know, it looks like there, it was like some sort of like orgy going on. So they're celebrating sexuality and enjoying it and living life and accepting who you are is really what everything in this song, in this video, and I mean, even in this album has been about. I think there could have been a little bit more done for the video. Like, I love the dance numbers, but this whole video was pretty much a dance number, except for the little shots that we got. I really would have liked to see some other kind of stuff cut in between the dance numbers so that we could see a little bit more of this world that she created. Judas and a cross. Obviously, this is gonna be some sort of religious story. Obviously, we got this guy with the crown on his head, which is Jesus. There was a couple people on the motorcycles. I think there was John, and then obviously there was Judas that I noticed. So a lot of biblical figures here. This is going to be a biblical story per se. But yeah, and they're all on a motorcycle gang. Jesus is in a motorcycle gang. One thing I noticed is the club called Electric Chapel. It was one of the name of the songs on the album, right? Electric Chapel, if I can remember correctly. Or am I thinking of... I don't know. I'm confused. No, I think that Electric Chapel was a name of a song on the album. So a nice little connection there to give some sort of connection to the overall artisticness of this era. And another thing I noticed is Lady Gaga... always in bra and panties. Every video. I mean, go with whatever you feel comfortable. It's a music video. If you feel comfortable in bra and panties, fucking rock that shit. And she definitely does rock that shit.
Love is so cruel, but still I would choose.
Lady Gaga now protecting Jesus from Judas, because obviously Judas is going to betray Jesus, if I can remember correctly. I really do like this biker aesthetic that she chose for the video, though. It just fits the overall kind of image of the album. You know, this very grungy, very hardcore, kind of, like I mentioned, heavy metal rock album. In the most biblical sense, I am beyond repentance. Fang hooker, prostitute, wench, vow meta mind. But in the cultural sense, I just speak in future tense. Judas kissed me in the fence, to where it comes the next time. Some shit's gonna happen. I wanna love you, but something's pulling me away from you. Jesus is my virtue, and Judas is the demon I cling to. And she's talking about how Jesus is her virtue, but Judas is the one that she clings to. And obviously, Judas is a very toxic guy, obviously. I mean, he's kind of an asshole, as we've seen in this video. But she's enthralled, and she's super into him. But some girls are just into bad guys, and Judas is a bad guy. But she knows that she should be with Jesus, because Jesus, you know, is her savior. I feel like she's talking about a little bit about kind of toxic relationships. You know, maybe she had a thing with Judas at some point and is still in love with him, or enthralled by him, or is just obsessed with him, to where, you know, she can't be saved at the same time, because, you know, she clings to it. And now she died. She got betrayed by Judas and Jesus, and then stoned to death. She was with Jesus, tried to warn Jesus about Judas, but she was still obsessed with Judas. Judas got betrayed by Jesus, but yet Jesus betrayed Lady Gaga and got her stoned to death. So really, the two relationships that they had were toxic, and it destroyed her in the end. That's what I think this video is about. I think it's talking about toxic relationships, or just the toxicity in general, maybe toxicity of relationships, maybe the toxicity of masculinity. As you see, kind of Judas is kind of like this man's man. He's starting fights, he's making out with women, he's just pouring alcohol on asses. And you notice when she goes to kind of like point the gun at him, a thing of lipstick comes out and puts it across his mouth, which I think was kind of symbolizing toxic masculinity. And it plays out in a very unique kind of biblical way, taking these biblical characters, carrying out the story that is known within, you know, religion in Christianity, and adding a little bit of her own as well, with her being stoned to death. Between the two music videos we just watched, I don't know which one I think I like more. To be honest, I think I like the Judas music video more than I like the Born This Way music video, because I feel like the story was a little bit more well executed in the Judas music video than the Born This Way music video. With Judas, it's a little more abstract visually, but it's done in a way to where the story is a little bit more clear than I felt with the Born This Way music video. But both great music videos, both a different direction visually compared to the Fame Monster and the Fame music videos. But let me know what you guys think about the music videos down in the comments, guys. What you like about the music videos, what you dislike about the music videos. Remember, new Lady Gaga reactions drop until we reach the end of her discography. So make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit that bell button so you get notifications of when those new videos drop. Hop on over to Instagram, Twitter, and Twitch. Give me a follow. If you would like to help support the channel, there's a Patreon link down in the description. Go and check that out if you got the time. And that is all I got for you guys today. So until next time, take care. Stay safe. I'll see you then.
Hey, thanks for watching Off the Deep End. Make sure you subscribe, comment, like, and share, and feel free to explore our channel and check out some of our other videos. Remember, new videos drop every week. Take care.